guys, I'm FastAnne, and in today's video, I've got something super, super special for you guys. I'm going to be playing the new Rainbow Six Siege season called Shadow Legacy. And first of all, a massive, massive thank you to Ubisoft for inviting me to play this new season. And in this video, I'll be showing you the new operator, the reworked Chalet, and some gameplay of the new season. Very, very exciting stuff coming up in this video. First off, I'm taking you through the new operator Zero, also known as Sam Fisher. It's a 2-speed, 2-armor, and it's got an Argus launcher gadget, which is basically a camera with a little laser, but we'll get into that later on. I'm taking you through his loadout first, and yes, finally, we're getting a new gun, and it's a SC-3000K with a couple new sights as well that we'll get into later on in this video. Also a couple of barrels that we're used to seeing, and you can pick an angled or vertical grip for this weapon. This is what the weapon looks like. Some say that it looks like Sam Fisher's gun back in the Splinter Cell days. His other primary gun is Bennett's MP7, also with one of the new sights. His secondary weapon is a 5.7 USG with an integrated suppressor. You can't take it off, and it gives a throwback to the Splinter Cell game. For a gadget, you can either pick frag grenades or a claimer. I'm gonna take you guys on a walk through the reworked Chalet. I'll show you some of the major changes and some of the changes that I personally really like. First off, we see that a lot of windows are now closed. If we approach the office balcony, we see a major change as well. No more spawn peeking from office door, as it is now blocked by your wall, and you'll be detected before you get a peek at the attacker spawn. Going towards garage, we see the top windows closed, but one new window above the garage, a dangerous window. Some windows around bar change too, and west main has a different look too. A lot of windows and doors are now closed, also the window towards trophy. Master bedroom balcony is gone. We'll get into that change later on as we enter the building. If we go to wine cellar, we see that this is now one big room, instead of a room with a small closet. Blue is now a hallway that leads towards another door in wine cellar. From fireplace, we see a hallway that connects to both bar and dining. Dining seems to be a lot more closed, and same goes for kitchen. The big window is gone, also providing less opportunities for a spawn peek. A hallway connects kitchen to west main, but we see that the stairs to office are gone. The stairs have been given another place. I hear you wonder, where could the stairs be? It's now in trophy, and it's called trophy stairs. Going up the trophy stairs, we go into this new room called solarium. Solarium is connected to master bedroom, as well as the bathroom on the right hand side. Master bedroom is connected to a room called piano, and that is connected to the office, which has gotten a lot bigger. Peep the nice wine cabinet, which is definitely a quality of life changer. Moving back towards piano, we can now walk to library hallway, and here we see that the windows to office balcony are now closed. Another nice change is that you can now get up on the roof of Chalet.
And
what? Hello. Oh, hi! I was like, what? I was being summoned from somewhere and I had no idea where from. Back to Zero, and his interesting new gadget. He has an Argus launcher, and it deploys small cameras that are also able to zap utility, or people. He has 4 of these. Every Argus has 1 zap, and it can get rid of things such as bandit batteries. You can deploy them on a floor, a barricade, a soft wall, a reinforced wall, any other wall, or a mirror window. On most surfaces, you're able to take a look on the other side of the floor slash wall as well. The cameras shine a soft yellow light, and the defenders can destroy them by shooting them. Like said before, the gadget does damage to people as well. 5 damage to be precise, and it can take out an injured person. The camera can destroy all kinds of gadgets.
Try to zap a Meister cam. I want to see what happens.
Nothing. No. Wow, that's disappointing.
I'm so sad now.
Yeah, same. It can't destroy a closed evil eye, but it will destroy an opened evil eye. Ooh, that
I'm
works.
Happy now.
Okay.
Let's go.
Yay, satisfied. It works well against a Goyu shield, especially if Goyu himself is close to that shield.
I'm trying to kill him with... Yes! What?
You got them.
Oh, wait, is my shield... Was my shield deployed for you guys or no?
No.
Look at that!
You can view both sides on a reinforced wall. And if you deploy it close to a mirror window, you can pop the canister.
Can you zap the mirror?
Can I? I can zap it, like yes, I can zap
okay.
it. It's a really nice gadget to gather some information or destroy some utility. Even after using the zap, you can still stay on the camera. But make sure to not get too caught up while checking your cameras.
Oh, what?
What happens to my camera?
I'm teasing you.
I didn't know.
Wait,
I was
what?
On my I was on my Argus gadget. Overall, Zero is an interesting new operator with a strong gadget. It can gather intel as well as destroy gadgets. A new gadget for attackers is the new Heartbeat Charge. It's a secondary gadget given to the following 8 operators: Montane, Fuse, Capitao, Ying, Lion, Finca, Nock, and Amaru. After deploying it, it will detonate immediately, unless it's stopped by a mute jammer. A bandit battery will destroy the gadget. It creates a hole big enough for you to crouch through or vault through, but they work both ways, and it can be dangerous. You can fit multiple gadgets next to each other, 3 gadgets on a double wall, but if they're not placed at the same time, 1 gadget will destroy the other if they are too close to each other. It also gives great possibilities for sneaky angles to hold.
You're dead.
You can put 2 heartbeat charges above each other. If you stand on the side where it's deployed, it will do 4 damage. On the other side, it doesn't do any damage at all.
How much damage does this do?
I wanna see 2. 4.
Nothing.
If you put 2 gadgets above each other, it will create a hole big enough for Montane to walk through with his shield extended. You can make multiple holes if you place the gadget at the same time, or if you destroy a mute jammer that was blocking the gadgets. They will detonate immediately after the mute jammer is gone. Perfect timing. We love to see it.
I have an idea.
It could be just me, but if you're holding the gadget, it reminds me of a specific thing. Okay, we'll just move away. Just nice little gathering with our triangles here.
Oh, that is all my.
Well, that's not gonna help.
I'm gonna place the bottom one then.
Place it.
Okay. Bandit can stop the hard breach gadget from detonating by placing a bandit battery on the wall.
Oh, God.
Like said, after destroying a mute jammer, the gadget will detonate immediately. In this season, we're also getting a few new sights. I've tested some of the scopes to give you an idea of what they look like. There's a new holographic sight. This will be given to a few operators, and some other operators keep their original holographic sight. The ACOG has a new name. It's now called the 2.5 scope. All DMRs will receive a new scope, the 3.0 scope. And can someone call the newspapers? Because Rook and Doc are losing their ACOGs. Rook will get the 2.0 scope, and Doc will receive the 1.5 scope.
Oh,
this
are
confuses
you,
me.
Are you flexing on me, Anne? With your 2x, well, I can only have 1.5. Okay, dude.
I'm sorry. I think the only operator on the defensive side to keep his ACOG is Vigil on the Boss G.
Mission successful.
I played around with a few of the new sights, and I definitely like them. Especially the new holographic sight and the 2.0 scope. There's one right above the hatch here.
Lying down behind the piano.
In these clips, you must have noticed something about the color of my sight, too. In the options, there is a new tab called Accessibility, where you can set a specific color accessibility preset. and you can change the optic color. You can also change its opacity. Another new thing is the reinforcement pool. This means that all defenders will now have a shared reinforcement pool of 10 reinforcements. Operators with a lot of utility can stop worrying about reinforcing now. On the top left of your screen, you can see the amount of reinforcements that are left. Even if there's just one defender, you still have 10 reinforcements, so you can create your own little bunker. We tried using the last reinforcement at the same time. Unfortunately, no spare magic reinforcement appears. 3, 2, 1, start. No! Oh, you get the option to just... okay. Siege just keeps on bringing new things this season, because they're also introducing Ping System 2.0. Every player will now have their own numbered ping marker that will stay with you for the whole match. You don't have to wonder who is pinging something anymore. You can also ping gadgets. If you scan someone's primary gadget, the operator will be revealed at the top of your screen. It's an easy way to communicate to other players, and I think it'll do especially well when you're solo queuing. Goyo's Vulcan shield is a tricky one to scan, however. If you scan the Vulcan attachment, even through the glass mirror, it will reveal that it's a Vulcan shield. Another big change is a rework of Thatcher's EMP grenades. They will now disable gadgets for 15 seconds instead of destroying them, giving you more than enough time to use a heart-breaching gadget. In the bottom left of your screen, as a defender, is a timer that will show you when and for how long the gadgets will be disabled. Okay. You can still pick up disabled batteries and place them again. But if you're in a hurry, you can also shoot your own battery and place another one.
Okay.
This is definitely gonna change up bandit tricking with the Thatcher rework.
Which color did you guys go with on your optics?
Teal.
Okay.
Teal?
Yeah.
What?
Honestly, it's so nice. Especially on the original ACOG, because it's got like a weird fade pattern.
Yeah, I have green. Looks really nice.
We also found a fun new mini game with Zero and Maestro.
Like, can we have a laser war? It's gonna be like what's that called? Like a Mexican standoff. Which camera wins?
Oh yeah. Okay, so you've got yours in the garage wall, I think. I'll put mine.
Yeah, you just put all of yours on that wall.
Yes, perfect.
Okay, I'm gonna try to take out all of yours.
Okay, yeah.
And you're gonna try to take out mine,
yes.
Okay?
Okay, fight. Oh, that's one! I dug it!
Okay. Whew, you got 3 lives, you can do this.
Yeah.
It's like Space Invaders.
That's nice.
Okay. Oh, damn. So that one doesn't have a shot, okay.
Oh. Oh, I don't know which one has a shot anymore. Oh, you won, because mine don't have a shot anymore. Nice.
I win.
Oh, I got zapped to death for that. Nice.
It's a challenge for you, I guess. I like that. That's a little mini game.
Oh yeah, that's awesome. That's how to do 1v1s in Year 5 Season 3.
Before it used to be 1v1s with knives.
Yeah.
In Year 5 we're doing with lasers.
Yeah,
okay,
I need to flip.
I'll be the zero now.
Yeah, perfect. I'll be Maestro.
Yeah, alright, I'm gonna boop. Boop. All right. Oh, that is hard. Oh. No!
Oh, I found the perfect way to do this.
Oh, oh, retreated!
Retreated, nice.
Okay, now it becomes really harder for you though.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah.
You have to like uke me. Oh. I'm never gonna go to the other. Azir, you need to stay on the camera. Oh. Oh, oh damn. Okay.
Okay. Yeah,
yeah. Oh, he is so sneaky. No! Well played.
Oh yeah. Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
All right. We're 1-1. Best of three. Six invitational. Oh. Who takes it home?
Oh jeez. I kinda want that shiny trophy.
This is it, Anne. This is what you've been training for.
I'm scared, not gonna lie.
Ah!
Oh!
You baited me. Okay. No.
This makes it hard. This,
you can shoot that one. You can shoot that one. I won't. Yep. Yes!
No!
Winner! Winner, winner, chicken dinner!
Oh my god. Oh, congrats. I'll take this as my loss.
GG.
GG. That was really funny. I enjoyed that.
Yeah, same. That was actually really fun.
A fun and nice run out to counter anyone that's in front of the snowmobile garage.
If you remain in this zone, you will be protected by hostiles. Four eliminated.
You can also use a C4 from snowmobile garage through the window in fireplace.
Yes!
No way.
Woo!
That's an insane angle.
Let's go! Oh, that is such a good C4.
Yeah, that's crazy. To do this, you need to stand on the back of the snowmobile and throw the C4 while walking forward. We found out that a single bullet doesn't go through two walls anymore. Hopefully, this will mean less lucky headshots.
We went three through.
But that took me two bullets.
That's so
inconsistent.
Okay, now I'm gonna sit here and you're gonna do a new shot.
Okay, wait, and let me find just the new one. Yeah.
Yeah, wait, okay, do you see me?
Yeah.
Alright.
Okay, so one, two.
Oh my god.
While playing this new season, I also experienced some fun moments.
outside West Main. Well, actually, it's not even West Main.
Oh, I got the diffuser.
West Main.
I got the diffuser.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, little ping.
Yeah, yeah, I can ping it. Yeah, I'll just
that
put
is
my
huge. Being able to wait, come here. Ah.
Yeah. Oh, this is a big brain stretch. They won't know that we're hiding here.
All right, and now wait. Do we have a camera there? Yeah, we do.
Oh, there's one in Solarium. Yeah. Awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Okay. So when I see someone, we both go off.
Oh, it's up to us now. Okay.
We got this.
Okay.
You cut out there. Can you repeat?
You're the last one. Complete a mission.
Thank you. Oh no, they're droning us.
Oh no. I'm not sure if the diffuser's still there. Oh, that was a
oh god.
Flash.
Oh no.
Oh, shit, they're right here.
Please.
Oh, I'm being spotted. Yeah, I'm gonna get wall banged.
Oh god.
Solarium.
Oh.
Pushing around towards the door. Left hand side.
No. Everything just turned to shit.
Where's the last one though?
Solarium.
I don't know.
The door. Same
he's
place.
He doesn't have time.
Yay!
Oh, it worked. I take all the credits for this strat. I'm gonna thank my mom, my dad, My dog. I don't have a dog, but my cats.
We found out that when you revive someone while looking forward, you'll be able to look in front of you while reviving. We're not sure whether this is a bug or intentional.
Oh yeah, ooh, that's interesting.
How?
Bomb location compromised. Like stand in front of him, look forward and then try to pick him up.
Let Ross get a clip.
I feel so used.
Try it, Ross.
And like I mentioned before in this video, he can get on top of the roof. But be careful not to walk too close to the edge. Oh, oops. I tried to repel there, but I accidentally walked off the rooftop.
You.
We also find out that you can knife the bushes in Chalet and then just take them any place on the map. We plan to put a lot of bushes on top of a hatch and then open it up.
Yeah, I got it. And it's being on.
It's completely okay, blocked the vision too. You can't see through it. I'm going below. I want it all to fall over me. Right, okay, I'm ready.
Okay, you guys staying here?
Yeah. Ready.
Yeah,
I'm breaching it.
God.
You're seeing all the different bushes move.
Oh my god. I'm completely covered in bush.
That is a perfect hiding spot.
Oh, this is amazing. Holy crap. Imagine it, and then there's just a guy hiding here.
Yeah.
Go on the camera.
Yeah, not obvious.
We just need to extend the prep phase with like a good 15 minutes. And this could be a legit strat, guys.
Everyone turn around and look at the camera. There's a camera above the door.
Where?
Okay.
What? Where is
oh,
it?
Oh, that's... Wait, I'm not seeing anything. Let me come in here.
I can't see anything. I'm just seeing leaves.
Three of us are hidden, apart from one thing standing up on my screen.
Okay. Oh,
yeah,
no,
that's better. That's better.
Okay, I'm gonna lay down this map. Oh. Wait, can you look a bit top right? A little bit? Just in the middle of us. Yeah, in the middle. Yeah, there it is. The money shot. One bush just rolled away and exploded everyone.
I had a lot of fun playing this new season on the test server. Again, a massive thank you to Ubisoft for inviting me to play the new season early. I will definitely play the test server when it's available on stream. So make sure to follow my Twitch channel. A link to that will be in the description below. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications on if you want to see more videos, because I upload a new video on every Sunday. I'll see you in the next video. Bye!